Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 82 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 142 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 143 and question 144. Question 143. You have a general purpose V1 Azure storage account named Storage1 that uses locally redundant storage or LRS. You need to ensure that the data in the storage account is protected if zone fails. The solution must minimize costs and administrative efforts. What should you do first? To understand it better, let's go to documentation portal of the Microsoft. We are in the documentation site of Microsoft.com and at the storage account overview page. We'll scroll down and we'll go to legacy storage account types. Here we can see that standard general purpose V1 account is the legacy type account which support LRS, GRS and RAGRS only, but zone redundancy is not supported by this one, so we will have to upgrade it to the another type of account. The pricing of general purpose V1 account would be high compared to other storage account types, so let's see how we can upgrade it or what is recommended account type to upgrade the standard general purpose V1 storage type. Back to first section, we'll go to migrate a storage account, and here we can see that upgrade to general purpose V2 storage account. You can upgrade a general purpose V1 storage account or a blob storage account to general purpose V2 account. We'll go to upgrade to general purpose V2 storage account page. We'll scroll down. The general purpose V2 storage accounts support the latest Azure storage feature and incorporates all the functionality of general purpose V1 and blob storage accounts. General purpose V2 accounts are recommended for most storage scenarios. General purpose V2 accounts deliver the lowest per gigabyte capacity prices for Azure storage as well as industry competitive transaction prices. Upgrading to a general purpose V2 storage account from your general purpose V1 or blob storage account is straightforward, means with the minimal efforts we can upgrade from general purpose V1 to general purpose V2 account. Back to the question. Therefore, the best option available to us would be option C, which is upgrade the account to general purpose V2. It is really easy to upgrade the account and that would minimize the cost as well. Furthermore, ZRS or zone redundant storage option is available to protect if any zone fails at the minimum prices. Question 144. You have an Azure subscription that contains the storage account shown in the following table. The name of account is Storage1 and the type of account is Storage V2 or general purpose V2 account, and having the performance of standard performance. Storage2 account, which is blob storage type and with the standard performance. Storage3, blob storage type account and having premium performance. Storage4 is a file storage type storage account and having premium performance. You plan to manage the data stored in the accounts by using lifecycle management rules. To which storage accounts can you apply lifecycle management rules? We need to identify the storage accounts where we can apply the lifecycle management rules. To understand it better, let's go to documentation site of the Microsoft.com. We are in the documentation site of the Microsoft.com. at the optimize cost by automatically managing the data lifecycle page. If we scroll down, here we can understand about lifecycle management policies for the storage accounts. We'll further scroll down. In this highlighted paragraph, it is explained that where we can apply the lifecycle management policies. Lifecycle management policies are supported for block blobs and append blobs in general purpose V2 storage accounts, premium block blobs and blob storage accounts. In our question, we do have standard general purpose V2 account. Second one is blob storage account in our question, and third option is given the premium block blob storage. And the fourth item in the question is file storage, which cannot have lifecycle management. Back to the question. Therefore, lifecycle management rules can be applied to storage 1, which is the storage V2 account. Storage 2 account, which is the blob storage account. So here we can apply the lifecycle management rules. And third one is block blob storage account, means storage 3 account. Here we can apply the lifecycle management rules. But in the file storage account, we cannot apply any lifecycle management rules. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.